Hey guys, I want to show you something which is quite hilarious. I just did a Google search on atheism, and when you go look up atheism and you look what's going on in the world, atheism is so stupid. Look at this. Look what this link says here. The first link that pops up says supporting civil rights. It's an atheist group, right? Supporting civil rights for atheists. And the separation, look how they spell separation, they spell that wrong, of church and state. So let's click this. Check this out. Now, look at the top. Supporting civil rights for atheists and the separation, they spell it wrong here, separation of church and state. Atheism is so stupid. Now, let me tell you another thing that's really stupid. Atheists will tell you there's really no objective purpose to their lives. But yet they're having a reason rally. Now, what are they going to talk about at the reason rally, that there's really no reason to have the rally? It's just madness in its purest form. So here you have it. We're looking at American atheists. They say that they support the civil rights for atheists, and they spell the separation of church and state. Oh, I thank God that I left the madness of atheism. And look, it shows they're all obsessed because the crosses on the highways, and like when soldiers die and they have crosses, on their grave site and stuff, the atheists are offended by that. Let the people be Christian. Quit harassing them, Be more American. Support what the founders believe that our rights come from God. But the atheists believe that our rights come from government. That's what's really dangerous about them. So I do believe that atheism is a bad religion. So now, on a brighter note, check this out. What you are about to see, I'm going to show you guys a live chat session where we challenged atheist evolutionists to provide proof and evidence that evolution was true, and they were not able to. We got it all recorded for you. You'll be able to see it in about a minute or two. Watch this. But some good news, 2,000 question evolution tracked order. As you know, you can get tracts from the Question Evolution campaign. You can hand them out. And soon, an enormous and hungry school of creationist piranha will begin devouring Darwinism. I agree. I think it's about time we get the wooden stake of truth and we drive it right through the heart of this dishonest, fictional Darwinian theory. So I want you to read about this. I'm going to put this link right below this video. Make sure that you read that. Now, you ready? You're in for a treat. We challenged atheist evolutionists to provide proof and evidence that evolution was accurate and correct, and they failed at the top of their voice. They failed miserably. We challenged the Reddit evolutionists. A lot of evolutionists hang out on Reddit, and we challenged them to come to our chat room and provide proof and evidence that evolution was accurate and correct, and they failed to do so. Check this out. You're now going to see the video of the evolutionist failing.
This makes me think that you're a misologist, you're playing out a denier, or you're just nuts. Because, first of all, there is. Let me explain to you. Think about what I'm trying to tell you. That's an intelligently designed process. I rest my case, Mike. Like I said, you have three options. You've definitely fulfilled the last one. Here you go, Shock. Thank you very much.
Instead of throwing it out, I used it. So, hey, Trevor, Turtle, the One, Chat Apple, Rich, R.D. Smith, Princess Phoenix, Octopus, Nathan Cannon, Mike, Megan, Mega, Magic Man, Leprechaun Rising. Doesn't that sound like a scary, terrifying movie? This Halloween, the world is not safe. Leprechaun Rising, rated R. Children not prohibited for its scariness. And hey, Clab, Kiwi, Izzy, Hicks, Fire Dragons, Cookie Dog, Contradictory Bible. Contradictory Bible. My spidey senses are going off. I think that guy might be an atheist. What do you guys think? Oh, it's over. Hey, I got to tell you guys something. The other day, oh, and we're now recording. We are now recording for the YouTube channel. Everything you say and do will be used against you. I want to tell you guys, we had some evolutionists in here the other day, bless their sweet little primate hearts. And what happened is I asked this question. Now, can I ask everyone here a question? How many people here believe in all of evolution, like that you came from primates or whatever? Like, how many people believe in micro and macro evolution? If you're courageous enough, okay, contradictory Bible, boy, I saw that coming. Okay, now, Mike, don't you believe in micro and macro? And Hicks, you do too? So, Hicks, do you believe micro and macro evolution to be true? And Mike, do you believe it? Now they're all shy now that we're recording. No, Mike, don't go to sleep. The fun's just starting. Oh, come on, Mike. That's what coffee's for, Mike. Dang it, I get here and you always leave. Why do you got to get up early tomorrow? You going to church? They have atheist churches now? El Unicornis Exponentia. All right. Well, Mike, why are you... Oh, yeah, you're in the military. All right, man, much respect. I got nothing but good to say to the people that are going to the military. Mike, I think you're going to the military, aren't you? Training? Awesome, man. All right, hey, much respect. Even though I disagree with your worldview and stuff, the UK and the United States are allies, and we'll all be going to war with Iran. Hey, Mike, I might see you on the battlefield when we go into Iran together. So I'll see you there. But, Mike, let me throw the grenade, because I've heard atheists have limp wrists, and I don't want the grenade falling at our feet, blowing us up. So I'm kidding, Mike. I know atheists that are awesome soldiers fighting for our right to believe in God. So, now wait a minute. You got this guy, I'm going to call you CB, saying God would never support war. Well, wait a minute. Which one was it? I thought God was the war god, according to Richard Dawkins. You atheists, you got to get your facts right. Either God likes war or he doesn't like war. All right. Well, let me get back to this so we could do this. Now, Mike, before you go to practice for military, I wanted to ask all just the – it's a very simple question. All the people that believe in macroevolution is true, here's the question. Type in the approximate number of how many fossils we have that prove macroevolution is true. Ready, go. Any number. Okay, the CB guy said 30. That's wrong. Nathan's right. Nathan, I like Nathan's being accurate. Okay, so do you guys see the problem? Now, if I said how many fossils have we collected, the fossil record's over a billion. We just don't have transitional fossils. So if you look on the internet and you do some research, we have over a billion fossils that we've found. So I just want everyone to know, you notice that no one says, well, we have CB, contradictory Bible, saying there's 30. Now, CB, would you type in two of the fossils that we found that prove transition, macroevolution? Could you type that in for us? It's probably next to the document you have that says God doesn't support war. It's probably right next to that. Okay, here's the thing. Guys, if there's no fossils, then everything that this whole macroevolution thing, we have to take it on, I hate to use this word, faith, blind faith. Now, when we came and we sat down on the chair here, I had faith that the chair was going to be a sturdy chair. When I got on the monitor, I had faith that it was going to, you know, I was going to be able to see on the monitor. But I have faith based on evidence and common sense that these things would work. Okay, now contradictory Bible says he needs some time. All right, so contradictory Bible, we want to have 30. I want 30 fossils that you said that show transition, between species of species of species and stuff. So it's over, guys. That's all you got to do is ask that. Would you guys mind terribly much if Viva, can I fly through the 15 questions? I promise I won't take a long time. Do you mind? Because I'm trying to do this to I'll go fast. Okay, no one's saying anything. Okay, Viva said it's okay. If any evolutionist want to get on the microphone while we're doing this, just let me know. And in the words of Ross Perot, we're all ears. Okay? These are the 15 questions that have the Reddit evolutionist stump days confused and stupefied. You know, not one Reddit evolutionist, none of them, have been able to answer these questions. Okay, how did life originate? Anyone want to talk about that? Do you know that even Paul Davy says nobody knows? How could a mixture of lifeless chemicals spontaneously organize themselves into the first living cell? Isn't it true that the evolutionist has to take this stuff on faith, since Darwinian evolution is pretty much silent on this? Isn't it? CB, we're still waiting, man. You got lots of time. Get your fingers Googling. We want to know the names of those fossils. So, CB, you're going to have lots of time. We got 14 more questions. The one, would you like to get on the mic and answer this question? How did the DNA code originate? Okay, you don't want to do it? Well, then quit complaining. Man. If you know what it reminds me of is there's a lot of armchair quarterbacks, and then when you throw them the football, they don't want to run down the field with it. Give me back the football. How did the DNA code originate? You know what's really interesting? When you look at the molecule and the complexity of the cell DNA, they're now saying 4.54 billion years is not enough time for it to evolve naturally. For everything to evolve by purely naturalistic means, it's over. It's over, guys. Francis Crick, who was the co-discoverer of DNA, double helix DNA, he looked at this. He said he don't really believe that he's got a problem with this Darwinian evolution. He believes that it had to have been seeded here maybe by meteorites. And he calls it the evolution of man and all this almost a miracle. It's interesting that he uses the word miracle, and he doesn't really believe that like a lot of people are now coming around to believe that 4.54 billion years still isn't enough for evolution to occur. Now that we know the cell, Darwin thought it was just a glob of goo. So did Huxley. Do you know, you guys in here, there's 23 of us in here, you guys know more about the cell than they did? I mean, those guys are riding around in horse and buggy. It's time that we get a wooden stake and we drive it through the heart of this fictional, dishonest, stupid fairy tale for adults, this evolution. What was that other, those other authors? Oh, Barrow and Tipler, they have the book I always tell you guys about, The Anthropic Cosmological Principle. They said they even just took 10 things that would have to occur for human evolution to be true, each of which, they said, guys, each of which is so improbable that before it could happen, the sun would have already ceased to be a main sequence star and would have incinerated the Earth. So I just don't have enough blind faith to believe in Darwinian evolution. See, he didn't have all the facts. Darwin didn't have all the facts, either did Huxley. They didn't know about this 32-component rotary motor like ATP synthase, which produces the energy currency, or robots like Kinesin. These things just can't evolve naturally. In fact, I'm going to show you some quotes in here where they show that we haven't even had any evidence of this evolution, which I'll go through this. Natural selection. Hey, Viva. I don't want to spoil the surprise. Maybe I'll let Viva. Viva, do you want to tell them? They might think an atheist or someone thought of natural selection. Did you want to tell them where natural selection came from on the mic? This is really interesting, you guys. This is not a Darwin's... it's skipping out? Are you guys hearing me okay, or is it just skipping out on Viva's? Oh, it's on his side? Okay. Well, the person that come up with this natural selection believed in God. Oh, you want to do it, Viva? Oh, now I'm stealing Viva's thunder. All right. Natural selection. Viva's going to tell you a little bit about it. But it wasn't Darwin's idea. Darwin did not come up really with that idea originally. So listen to this. This is interesting. Go ahead, Viva.
It's been kind of like getting glitchy a little bit because like I know that there has been 15 questions. Yes, I know that like sometimes there's been a little bit of a glitch. I emailed the Meet Cheap and they've been saying that their data center is kind of glitchy a little bit, but I just wanted to let you know, Shock. Sometimes my sound comes in and out a little bit, but now I have this paper right here. And I want to show you guys, and so you know that I'm not making it up. As you can see, natural selection, creationist idea right here. And matter of fact, it was a professor. Some of these people were. This is a professor from anthropology, Lauren Isley.
Well, I think Viva was a pre-trib rapture believer, and I think he just got raptured and we're all left. Viva, I guess you're not a pre-trib rapture believer. We thought you were raptured and all of us are still here. Okay, go ahead, Viva. That's good because I thought maybe I had something to worry about. Okay, so Viva's going to finish up on the natural selection.
It's been a common myth at the time. Okay, now it's bouncing around. Okay, Viva the Viva. Yes. I just basically... were you shocked? Were you just here when I schooled Mike? Were you here when I just schooled the crap out of him about, he goes, intelligent design does not have a model. And I'm like, really? Well, humans create plasmids and they're like, you know, and that's an intelligently caused thing to happen. And then he's all like, no, it's not. And I'm like, well, because that's not a correct model. And I'm like, well, because we do it because we want to create something. Therefore, there is a model. We want to create medication. We, you know, what do you think they're curing malaria with? With their mind. Of course, they're doing it with they're doing it with intelligently designed plasmids, and they're altering the genetic sequences of something in order for them to, cause a cure. I wanted to be very clear that it's intelligent design is a creationist idea. It originated from before. And what happened was that as I say, that evolution is a universal religion and it incorporates everything, kind of like it's like the Catholicism. Nothing against our Catholic brothers, but it's almost like it incorporates everything. And what they fail to realize is this natural selection idea. And what happens is they are always about random mutation. But the only thing that is not random is the natural selection, right? Because that's a creationist idea. Creationists don't ride on the fact of ignorance. We don't. We ride on the facts of facts. That's pretty self-explanatory. Now, it's not like it's not that we want to wish upon a star. As a matter of fact, we look at harmony. We look at things. And when we saw natural selection... we started, there was creationists that said, look, there is things that try to survive, they struggle, and of course, there's an incorporation in evolution. Because if you think about it, natural selection, the idea, because of its order, contradicts the random mutation idea. And it's kind of a contradiction. Yes, leprechaun, but no cursing. But yes, I just wanted to illustrate to you guys that it is always and it's always been a creationist idea. And if you guys want to do it, I will paste the link back up again so you guys know that it is not. And there's also was a secular humanist even admitting the fact that DNA and the idea of natural selection comes from creationists. We're the ones that do the science, not the evolutionists.
All righty, thank you. Yeah, so natural selection, all that is God's creation, and it has nothing to do with macroevolution. And look what it says. Natural selection is not a creative process. It might explain the survival of the fittest, why certain genes benefit creatures more in certain environments, but not the arrival of the fittest, where the genes and creatures came from in the first place. So let's mosey right along with questions. And if any evolutionists want to get on and talk about any of these questions, feel free. How did new biochemical pathways, which involve multiple enzymes working together in sequence, originate? See, they couldn't evolve because the enzymes have to work together in sequence. Every pathway in nanomachine requires multiple protein enzyme components to work. How did lucky accidents create even one of the components, let alone 10 or 20 or 30 plus at the same time, often in a necessary program sequence? Now, this is a problem. This is why CB, the guy who's still frantically looking for the transitional fossils, and we've been talking now over 10 minutes, he still can't find any. This is why Franklin Harold, evolutionary biochemist, wrote, oh, we must concede that there are presently no detailed Darwinian accounts of the evolution of any biochemical or cellular system, only a variety of wishful speculations. Richard Dawkins talked about how things look designed. He admitted it. He said, biology is the study of complicated things that have the appearance of having been designed with a purpose. Yeah, CB, I can't go to any websites, but feel free to type in the number of fossils or the name of a fossil. Just one. Give me a fossil that proves transition. Even just one. Let's start there. Let me know what it was. Oh, notice, he doesn't have fossils. Now he's conceding there's no fossil. All right. Fossils would be evidence, though, so you don't have fossils or evidence. All right. Now another thing, too, is Dawkins has said in debate he's an agnostic. So do any atheist evolutionists want to talk about that, how Dawkins is an agnostic now? He's unsure about his atheism. Now, we've been hearing this silly thing saying that he's an agnostic atheist. Well, then that means, because Dawkins said he's like a 6 out of 7 on his agnostic scale, then that means he's 99% unsure about his atheism. So if you want to say Dawkins is an agnostic atheist, what that really means, literally, is that he's unsure about his atheism. Well, we all know that. How did multicellular life originate? How do these cells adapted to individual survival learn to cooperate and specialize? How did they do that? And they created complex plants and animals. Maybe this is why Darwin is Dawkins. Maybe this is why Dawkins is unsure about his atheism. How did sex originate? Asexual reproduction gives up to twice as much reproductive success for the same resources as sexual reproduction. So how could the latter ever gain enough advantage to be selected? This is why the Reddit evolutionists, I hope someone clicks below this video and sends this to the Reddit evolutionists. I was very disappointed in their performance. We had one guy, one Reddit evolutionist that came here and he answered one question and then he went to answer a second question and after that he just gave up because he realized that evolution is an epic fail. It's a fairy tale for adults. How could mere physics and chemistry invent the complementary apparatuses needed at the same time? This is the typical what came first, the chicken or the egg dilemma. Question 9, and this is the one we still got CB there. CB was honest. He says no fossils. This proves it right here, guys. Lack of evidence is not evidence. Lack of evidence is not evidence. And by the way, the one I see you're back, if you'd like to type in some fossils that we've collected that show transition, by all means, go ahead and type it in. We're willing to look at it. Oh, yeah. Hey, J3. Yeah, man, I was hoping you'd come in because I got to chat with you. We're recording right now doing the 15 questions. Yeah, we definitely will chat tonight for sure. It's only 7 o'clock over here in California. It's raining. Darwin noted the problem, and it still remains. The evolutionary family trees and textbooks are based on imagination, not fossil evidence. What I'll do is I'll turn my Skype on like right after this. You know, Stephen Jay Gould, who is an evolutionist, he admits it. He says, look, the extreme rarity of transitional forms in the fossil record persists as the trade secret of paleontology. Where are these fossils? Now, I got to tell you guys two funny things. One, I actually had an evolutionist in here say, well, it's like a conspiracy. The creationist scientists are buying up the fossils. This is what he said, right? I don't believe it. I know you guys don't either. He goes, they're buying up any of these transitional fossils, and they're buying them, and they're hiding them from the public. I go, really? I said, that's just ridiculous. That's what he believes. I go, well, how do you know they're buying up the fossils? Where do they get them? And he goes, well, I don't know, but that's probably what they're doing. Oh, my gosh. Come on, guys. Once my evolutionist friends and Reddit, if you're listening to this, my Reddit evolutionist friends that failed so miserably in answering these 15 questions, if you're listening to this and you've now resorted to saying that creationist scientists are buying all the fossils and hogging them up, the transitional fossils, you know that you've now strayed from science and you're now in the twilight. So, oh, it's over. This is a major problem. I remember Micah was talking about this too. Remember, I don't know if Micah's there. Remember, Micah, you were talking about living fossils. How do living fossils remain unchanged over supposed hundreds of millions of years? They're not changing even after hundreds of millions of years. This is the death of evolution, ladies and gentlemen. I believe, I have no doubt in my mind, we're going to see it in our lifetime. Get the wooden stake of truth, and let's drive it through the dishonest, stupid heart of evolution. Let's get this wooden stake of truth, and help me, ladies and gentlemen, drive the wooden stake through it. Look, it's dying anyways. Let's put it out of its misery. It's time evolution has gone extinct. Look, Darwin was riding around in a horse and buggy, and they thought the cell was just a blob of goo. Remember we talked to you about that? And now they're saying with the complexity of the cell DNA, all these things, there's just not enough time for random chance to cause this complexity. It's over, guys. Look, you remember that movie Weekend at Bernie's where they carry the dead guy around with them and they try to pass him off like he's alive? Well, that represents evolution, and we all know he's dead. I don't care if you put sunglasses on Bernie, if that was the dead guy's name, or a hat, and you try to prop him up and stuff. Look, he's dead. Everyone knows it. It's game over. Close the refrigerator. The light's off. The Jell-O's jiggling. The pudding's getting cold. It's over. No one's buying it. Look, if everything evolved and we invented God as per evolutionary teaching, what purpose or meaning is there to human life? Now, I would like to ask this. For example, to the atheist in the room, do you believe that you don't have a mind, that you're just all natural? Are there any atheists in here that are determinists and you just believe? Hey, Joe. Joe said hi. So, any? See, let's do like a little test. Let's say I told you to think of a pink elephant, right? Well, if they were to do an autopsy on you and open up your brain, they would not be able to find this pink elephant. This is not a natural, this isn't just cells and bone structure. This is your mind actually being able to create these things. There's something else there besides just naturalism. We talked about objective morality. We talk about that all the time. And I've asked atheists, evolutionists, do you believe there's such thing as things that are good all the time and some things that are evil all the time? And they'll say yes. And I go, well, this is objective morality. How does blind chemistry create mind, intelligence, meaning, altruism, and morality? If everything evolved and we invented God as per evolutionary teaching, what purpose or meaning is there to human life? Now, if you're an atheist and you're in the room, I would like to ask you, what purpose is there to your life? Not to put you on the spot, but you're all logged in with nicknames, so no one knows who you are. This is what I tell Viva. Viva's got an issue with this one, and I do too. Viva can't stand the just-so storytelling. I can't take it either. What we're saying is, notice it says, why is evolutionary just-so storytelling tolerated? That's like CB in the room here. He's like, yeah, we have all types of transitional fossils. We have 30 of them, and he just shoots a number off the top of his head, right? And then when I say, well, where are they? What are the names of them? He doesn't have any. That's what's called a just-so story. Evolutionists often use flexible storytelling to explain observation. Well, because it's a fairy tale. To explain observations. Now, CB's spamming the room 10 times about molecules. Molecules are not fossils. And if you're talking about DNA, I think DNA clearly is not good for Darwinian evolution. DNA is empirical proof of design. Oh, that's what I wanted to tell you guys. Stephen J. Meyer had a there's a video you can look for it on YouTube. I think it's called The DNA Enigma. And he talked about this. He said that it's information, and the scientists can't figure out how this information got there. And do you know what he did? He said that, and Viva, this is what you were talking about earlier, man. He said, you can use intelligent design in science. He said he used the same exact method that Darwin did. And Darwin used a method called the best explanation of the evidence. Best explanation of the evidence based on prior experience. So what Stephen Meyer said he did is he looked at the information of DNA, and he said, what is the best explanation of this? what other coding system has existed without intelligent design? And if you even use Darwin's method, which is based on, you know, the best explanation of the evidence, you clearly come up with intelligent design being the best explanation for DNA. So even using the method that Darwin used, DNA is empirical proof of intelligent design. Where are the scientific breakthroughs due to evolution? Mark Kirshner, he's a doctor, the chair of the Department of Systems Biology at Harvard. He said, in fact, over the last 100 years, almost all of biology has proceeded except evolutionary biology itself. Well, you know, that's horse and buggy fictional view of Darwinian evolution. He says molecular biology, biochemistry, physiology have not taken evolution into account at all. Notice that evolution actually hinders medical discovery. If we want to benefit society and we want to help medical discovery, it's time we catch up with modern science. You know, we have the electron microscope now. We know more about the complexity of the cell. We know about DNA. Darwin and Huxley, they didn't even know any of this. They were too busy feeding their horse or something. Look, evolution also fails the scientific method. Science involves experimenting to figure out how things work, how they operate. Why is evolution, which is a theory about history, taught as if it is the same as this operational science? You cannot do experiments or even observe what happened in the past. Now, if we had some transitional fossils, maybe we could use that, but as you can see in the room here, the evolutionists are dazed, confused, stumped, and stupefied. They don't know where these fossils are at. Now, look what Richard Dawkins said. He was asked if evolution has been observed, and I'm going to show you in a moment, this is why you don't want to let a biologist like Richard Dawkins, you don't want to let them out of the lab too often. He said, evolution has been observed. It's just that it hasn't been observed while it's happening. That's a dishonest way of saying it hasn't been observed. Richard Dawkins should get a dictionary and look what the word observed means and what... The question was if evolution has been observed, and he says it hasn't been observed while it's happening. Oh, it's over, folks. It is time we get a wooden stake of truth and we drive it through the heart of this fictional, dishonest theory. Worldview of evolution. It's a religion. Viva, you were saying this earlier. Okay. Why is a fundamentally religious idea a dogmatic belief system that fails to explain the evidence taught in science classes? It's religion. It's religion. Karl Popper, a famous philosopher of science, said Darwinism is not a testable scientific theory. We just talked about that. But metaphysical religious research program. Michael Ruse, who's an evolutionist science philosopher, he admitted it. He said evolution is a religion. This was true of evolution in the beginning, and it is true of evolution still today. If you can't teach religion in science classes, why is evolution being taught? It is a religion. Okay, let's go to hey, CB left. CB left. I was just about to go to him. Remember, he was supposed to find those transitional fossils, and he left the room. Oh, it's over. Oh, Joe, hi, Joe. How many transitional fossils do we have? Bear with me, guys. Oh, no problem, Viva. Yeah. Okay, Joe says he doesn't know the exact number. Give me an... Oh, Joe, they've gotten to you. All right. Joe, look, when you find the number... Guys, here's the question you want to ask our evolutionist friends. Bless their sweet little heart. Ask them this question right here. Why are the expected countless millions of transitional fossils missing? Okay, Hicks, so let me ask you this. What is a bat? Because Hicks is saying every fossil is transitional. Well, Hicks, what did a bat transition from? What was it before it was a bat? Because you know a bat and a whale are both mammals and vertebrates. So according to you, they would have a common ancestor. So a Hicks, what did a bat used to be? Yeah, Trevor, I got to get that from you, man. I would love to try that one. Let me click the little file thing here. See if it's here. Wow, you guys upload a lot of good stuff. Okay, Hicks is unable to answer that question. See, here's the problem. If everything was transitioning from another thing, we should have millions upon millions upon millions of transitional fossils. But we don't. We don't have any of these transitional fossils. We have about a billion total fossils that we found over time. But we don't have the... Okay, Hicks says no idea. He's answering my question. He doesn't have any idea. He's not a fossil person. Well, Hicks, let's do this, okay? Why not go ahead and don't say something is true till you have evidence of it? See, this is why I left atheism, guys. Do you know that atheism has no proof and evidence that it's true, accurate, or correct? That's why I know, Hicks, you're an atheist. That's why you don't want to be an atheist, because it's based on no evidence. Now Z14, let me ask you, because you're a motorcycle rider, or 214. You're not a motorcycle rider. I'm sorry. There's a motorcycle called Z14, which is pretty good. Yeah, Hicks, I've seen what some of the evolutionists do, and it's very dishonest. Can I show you? That's why I always ask for the actual fossils. What name is it? Because let me show you what the evolutionists do. We'll go to the whiteboard. Okay, watch this. Here's what they do. Now, I'm just going to use squares and circles because it's a lot faster for me. What they'll do is they'll get one species of animal here, let's say the square, and then they'll get another one over here, and they'll put it side by side as pictures, right? I kid you not. You guys have seen this, right, Viva? Viva and Micah, you guys have seen this. Then what they'll say is they'll say this over time transitioned into that. Well, no. Just by going ahead and putting things on a website next to each other doesn't mean that that's true. What would we need to prove that? You guys know what we would need. What is it? Let's do it. We would need... fossils. Right. So pictures on a page do not mean evidence at all. I don't know. Hey, Micah, are you able to get on the mic? If not, it's okay. I don't know if Micah's there. But Micah always, when he explains what we mean, is here's what we should mean. Here's what we mean by this. If everything was transitioning, right, and let's do it like this, we should have a series of changes in the fossil record. And these are these transitions. We should have them here like this. Because after all, that's what you got. I'm just saying what you guys are saying. Well, 214, we found over a billion fossils. We have no shortage of fossils. We found over a billion. What we're talking about, we don't have is the transitional fossil. So what you would see is you would see change within the fossil record. But we don't really have that. This right here, you don't really have. You'll have slight change, like how there's different types of cats, different types of dogs and stuff, but we don't see change outside of boundaries. You know, we don't see that, like how you guys were talking about Lucy earlier today. Joe, let me ask you again. Joe, type in a name of a fossil, what the species was. Just type in one. Just one, guys. Because usually what you guys say is this. They'll type one in, right? And let me do this, and then we'll wrap up. I got to take a Skype call. They'll type one in, and it's a fish. This is usually what it is. It's a fish, right? So then they'll say, and it changed. You know, it changed. Well, it's still a fish. You know how, like, you have different types of cats and different types of dogs and all that. This is microevolution, where you have change within limits, you know. But what we're talking about is macroevolution. Back to that slide thing real quick. Yeah, this thing here. Okay. Let me close it. This is what we're talking about. So here's the thing. Who was it, Hicks? Was it you that said everything is a transition, or was it the one? Which one of you guys said that? It wasn't you, Joe. It was Hicks. Hicks, you're wrong. You're wrong, my friend. Look what even Harvard paleontologist Stephen Jay Gould wrote. The extreme rarity of transitional forms in the fossil record persists as the trade secret of paleontology. So that's why this is, if you guys are noticing what's happening, is we're asking direct questions. What are the name of these fossils? What did they transition into? And they don't have it. There's nothing there, guys. You're just grasping at straws. Now, if it was true, like what Hicks was saying, think about it, guys. With all the types of species we have, we should have millions upon millions upon millions of these transitional fossils, and we don't. When you really think about it, I don't know what Darwin was thinking. It doesn't make sense. Even though he did real, look what it says, Darwin noted the problem. Even in his day, they still had this problem. So I think it's obviously clear that evolution has some very serious problems. We just went through 15 of them right here. And the evolutionists in the room have been dazed, stumped, confused, and stupefied. So I want to give you guys a challenge, okay? Joe, I want to ask Joe, Hicks, and whoever the other guys were, I want to give you guys a challenge. I want you to write out a little script on how you would answer question 9 and have fossil evidence ready, okay? Joe, are you for that? Hicks, are you willing to do that? 214, are you willing to do that? We want you guys, I'm going to give you time. Look at the question. Question 9, and I'm going to put this video on my YouTube channel. And what we want you guys to do is we want you to answer this question as honestly as you can. We had a guy that was on YouTube. He was kind of dissing creationists. And by the time I got emailing him back and forth, he actually said he does believe God is the creator of all things. He actually said that. And that they did like a long 15-question answer to the video. The guy that was in charge of it all, he even admits that he believes God is the creator of all things. So thanks for – I'm going to stop the video, guys. Thanks for watching. I have to – I'm going to go to the kitchen, get a cup of tea and stuff. Then I got a Skype call. J3, I'll turn my Skype on. Just give me a few. But I guys, I'm looking at these you guys uploaded some new slides. This is – oh, wait a minute. I'm in the wrong thing. Let me see here. Hey, Trevor – if you could, is there a way you can give the slide to, oh, these are all PDFs. I see. They're all PDFs. Yeah, these aren't PowerPoint. So, all right, man, awesome.